Hello everyone. The reason that we purchased an NVMe SSD drive without DRAM cache is usually because these drives are affordable, like this Kingston NV1 NVMe drive, which is a 2 TB NVMe drive that I purchased not long ago. So I installed this drive in my Dell Inspiron, but I didn't get the speed that I was expecting from this drive. And I didn't want to pay much more. So I searched in the same budget range and I found this Timetec 2 TB NVMe SSD drive that is roughly the same price as the Kingston NV1, but it has better specifications and most importantly, it has 2 GB of DRAM cache. So now to find out if these better specifications that are on paper are really better in the real world usage, I'm gonna be performing speed tests on both drives to compare them. And I'm gonna also be performing a temperature test on these drives because some reviews say that the Timetec drive gets really hot. And when NVMe SSD drives get hot, they start throttling and the transfer speed will be reduced drastically. Before we start the speed test and the heat test, let me show you a glimpse of the specifications of each drive. So these are the specifications of both drives. I have put on the top the specifications that are different between these two drives. And you notice right away that the Timetec NVMe drive is really faster than the Kingston NV1 on paper at least. And the most notable difference is the terabytes written. When the Kingston only provides 480 terabytes written lifespan, the Timetec NVMe drive provides 1800 terabytes written lifespan, and this is huge. And I think this is due to the construction technology because the Timetec uses TLC, whereas the Kingston uses QLC. The only one advantage that the Kingston has here in this comparison is that it is thinner than the Timetec, so it has components only on one side of the drive, and this makes it compatible with more thinner laptops. Now for the warranty, on the box, both of them say that they have 3 years warranty. So on the Timetec, on the box of the Timetec, if you look at the box, it says 3 years warranty. But if you go to the website and to Amazon website also where I purchased this NVMe drive, it says that all M2-2280 drives that are purchased after August 1, 2020, they have 5 years warranty. So here there is like a discrepancy in the information, but I'm gonna take them for their word. Don't forget that Timetec is a new company and is still being like establishing its name, whereas Kingston is a really well-established name that is a big player in the data storage field since years ago. That being said, let's start now with a speed test to confirm all these numbers, or maybe also to deny all these numbers. The first test I'm performing here is Windows boot time, and this is Windows 11. And Windows boot time uses many small files, and the NVMe drive that is faster in reading, it will win here, of course. And with no surprise here, the Timetec NVMe won by a huge margin, so it started in 18 seconds, whereas the Kingston started in 26 seconds. By the way, if you're liking this video so far, please comment on it and consider subscribing to my channel and giving this video a thumbs up. In this next test, I'm copying a large file, which is a 33 gigabytes file, from the same drive to the same drive so that to get accurate results. And here also the Timetec NVMe drive is faster than the Kingston, but not by a huge margin. So the Kingston was averaging 600 megabytes per second, whereas the Timetec NVMe drive with DRAM cache, I remind you, it was averaging 775 megabytes per second and it won by 11 seconds. In the small files copy, we see here that both drives are really almost the same speed. And this shows that the theoretical speed is really of not a big importance in this type of operation. So small files copy is really taxing on any hard drive. And here the Kingston won by 2 seconds. It's not a big margin, but nevertheless it won. And we notice that the DRAM here cache doesn't come into play in this type of operation. This next test is an overheat test. So this is because I read some reviews saying that the Timetec SSD tends to overheat if you stress it. So here what I've done is that I launched a program called Cypher that writes zeros and random numbers to the SSDs while I was copying also from my Samsung SSD to these SSDs 149 gigabytes of data. And after a while, both SSDs, of course, overheated, but they were still working. The Kingston started throttling and it was having trouble copying the files, and it took almost 26 minutes to finish this job. And the maximum temperature it reached was 66 degrees. Whereas the Timetec finished the job in 12 minutes and the maximum temperature it reached was 74 degrees Celsius. Now, I don't know if this will affect its longevity, but to be frank, it's rare to be stressing the SSDs while copying data on it. So I also performed the same action, which is copying 149 gigabytes of data on these both SSDs without stressing it with Cypher. And both SSDs didn't overheat and they finished the job in much, much shorter time. And now in this test, I am launching the game Fortnite. This is a really heavy game. It's like 35 gigabytes. And here the Timetec launched it in 34 seconds, whereas the Kingston NV1 launched it in 39 seconds. And this is not a big difference. The following test is a Crystal DiskMark benchmark test. And this test will show you if the numbers that the manufacturer claim are really attained on your PC. So here, as you notice, that the Kingston is surpassing even the numbers that they were providing, whereas the Timetec here SSD NVMe drive is below the numbers that they were claiming in the specifications. So it's getting only 2.7 gigabytes per second for the sequential read speed and 2.6 gigabytes per second for the sequential write speed, whereas they were claiming 3.4 gigabytes per second as read and 3 gigabytes per second as write. And this is unfortunate. At the end, what drive should you choose? For me, I chose the Timetec drive for the following reasons. First, it is very attractive budget-wise. Second, it has many features on top of the Kingston drive and also on top of entry-level NVMe drives that don't have DRAM cache. So it has DRAM cache. It has very high terabytes written lifespan, which is 1800. And also, it is much faster than the Kingston NV1 and also from other entry-level NVMe SSDs. So even though the speeds they were claiming they couldn't be attained on Crystal DiskMark, they were very good. So I could get 2.7 gigabytes per second read sequential and 2.6 gigabytes write sequential, which is really good. And the other numbers were also good. Now the Kingston, if you wanna choose it, also it is a very good choice. And you mainly choose the Kingston for two reasons, in my opinion. First, because it's a very well-known brand. Second, because it is thin, so it has the components only on one side of the SSD, and this makes it more compatible with laptops that are really very thin. At the end, let me remind you that I have Amazon affiliate links for both products in the description below. If you make a purchase using one of my links, I will gain a small percentage at no cost to you, and this will help my channel greatly. I want to thank you all for watching, and I hope that my video will help you in your choice of getting an NVMe SSD. I'm Eloy. Until next time.